Welcome to my series of videos, Know Your Medicine. Today we are going to discuss about a very commonly prescribed hormonal pill called as a cabergoline. What is cabergoline? Why it is used? For what condition it is prescribed? In which condition we cannot use this? What are the side effects? And much more. We are going to discuss all that in our today's topic. So stay tuned with me. Now, before I begin this video, I have a very special important information. If you want to watch this video in Hindi language, then on the I button, there is a link. You can click on that link and this video will be played in Hindi language for you. अगर आप इस वीडियो को हिंदी भाषा में देखना चाहते हैं तो ऊपर आई बटन पे एक लिंक है. अगर आप उस लिंक पे क्लिक करेंगे तो इस वीडियो को आप हिंदी भाषा में पाएंगे. So let's begin our today's topic, cabergoline. Now see, cabergoline is a very commonly prescribed hormonal pill. And when we prescribe this medicine to the patient, they have a plenty many questions in their mind. Doctor, why is this drug used for? Am I the right person? What all side effects I can have? I'm planning to get pregnant. Will it affect my pregnancy chances? And many more. Few questions patients ask to their doctors, and sometimes they don't ask, and then they go here and there and they try to search on a Google and then they get scared. To clear all your doubts about the cabergoline, I have made this special video. So stay tuned with me. We are going to discuss in depth. So first, what is cabergoline? Cabergoline is a hormonal pill. It is not your ordinary cough and cold medication which you can take otherwise. You have to take this medicine only if it is prescribed by your doctor. Now if we talk about the chemically, then cabergoline belongs to a ergot derivative and it belongs to a drug called as a dopamine receptor agonist. Now this cabergoline drug is also called as a prolactin inhibitor. That means it inhibits the prolactin hormone production. Now, cabergoline drug has been put a patency from the year 1980. And from the year 1993, this drug is very commonly used by the medical professionals. Now, prior to cabergoline, we used to prescribe another drug called as a bromocriptine. But the bromocriptine had a major two problems. One, that drug was a short acting, and secondly, those drug was very intolerable to many people. To overcome both of these issues, a new drug came into the picture, and that's the cabergoline. Cabergoline has now almost replaced the bromocriptine. However, we do prescribe bromocriptine in certain situations. So what is this cabergoline and where do we use this? See, cabergoline drug can be prescribed in a many conditions. The important conditions I am going to discuss now. So the very first condition is a hyperprolactinemia. Now what is hyperprolactinemia? Whenever the prolactin hormone concentration increases in your blood, we call it as a hyperprolactinemia. By the way, what is prolactin? What is its action? What should be the right balance of the prolactin? If it increases, what all problem can happen and how do we treat that? I have made a special videos for that. If you have not watched those videos, please consider to watch those videos so that you will get a more information. So that is a hyperprolactinemia. Second condition is a prolactinoma. Now prolactinomas are nothing but a small tumors of the pituitary gland. Many a time this prolactinoma can be a functional and they secrete prolactin hormone, and sometimes they can be a non-functional. In both the conditions, we use the prolactin reducing hormone cabergoline. Cabergoline has found to reduce not only the prolactin hormone level, but it also reduces the size of the tumor. So that's the second condition. Third condition we use this is for the Parkinson's disease. Now Parkinson's disease is actually, it's a neurological problem, usually happens in a senior citizen. And in this condition, the people usually have a abnormal jerky body movements. Besides that, we use this medication for the lactation suppression. Now what is lactation? The moment a pregnant woman delivers a child, she starts producing a milk, and this process is called as a lactation. And many a times when we do not want to continue the lactation, in such situation we use cabergoline to suppress this. Now why do we do that? Many a times, let's assume that if a woman has delivered a child and due to some unfortunate incident the child dies. In that case, what happens to the rest of the breast milk? So we suppress that with the help of this medication. Sometimes after the delivery, the child has been admitted into an ICU setting and wherein the mother and the child is separated and mother cannot give milk. Again, in that situation, we use cabergoline. Sometimes due to some mental or a physical problem, a mother cannot breastfeed a child, or a mother is taking certain medications which might pass in the breast milk and which can be contraindicated for child, or sometimes a woman chooses not to breastfeed a child. In all this condition, we have to do a lactation suppression. If we don't do that, then this milk will accumulate inside your breast tissue and that can cause an infection, even a mastitis. To prevent all this, we do the lactation suppression. Besides that, cabergoline is also prescribed in the infertility. Now, infertility is a condition wherein it is difficult for a couple to conceive. Yes, infertility is a problem of a couple and it is not a problem of a single person. So there are plenty many reasons for the infertility. There can be male factors, there can be a female factors. And there are plenty many factors which contributes to the infertility. But if your infertility happens due to the higher level of the prolactin, then the cabergoline can be useful. In fact, there are 80 to 85% of the people ovulate after starting the cabergoline drug if their high prolactin was a reason for them not to ovulate. So that's how effective it is. Again, cabergoline will be effective only if infertility is contributed by the high prolactin and may not be otherwise. Besides that, we also use cabergoline for a condition called as a acromegaly. Now, what is acromegaly? Acromegaly is again, it's a hormonal problem. This happens when your body has a higher level of the growth hormone. Growth hormone is another very important hormone which is produced by the pituitary gland, and this hormone is responsible for our growth and development. But when the growth hormone increases in your blood, especially in adults, we call it as an acromegaly. In this, the person usually have an abnormal face. They can have a bigger size hand and a legs also. They might develop a various kind of a lumps all over the body. Now, because prolactin hormone and a growth hormone are chemically very similar to each other, when we use a cabergoline drug, they also gives a good response in an acromegaly patient. Besides that, we also use cabergoline for another hormonal condition called as a PCOS or a PCOD. That's a polycystic ovarian syndrome, which usually happens in women. In PCOS women also, they have a higher level of the prolactin. There also we use a cabergoline. Besides that, we also use cabergoline in certain uterine fibroids. These are small masses or lumps which happens in a women's uterus, and this can contribute to many other menstrual period issues. So in that condition also we use cabergoline. So these are the certain indications where we use on label. There are certain off label usage also. And that the first condition is when a person is taking any antidepressant or antipsychotic drugs which belongs to the class called SSRI or a selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors. When a person takes this class of a medication, their prolactin tend to be increased, and sometimes it also creates a hypogonadism kind of symptoms wherein a person might experience that their sexual drive or a libido is lost. They might also experience an erectile dysfunction in a man. To prevent all this, we also use a cabergoline drug. Besides that, there's one more condition called as a restless leg syndrome. Again, this is a mental problem wherein a person has a severe urge to move their leg, and if they don't do that, their body goes into the restlessness. To prevent this and to treat this also, we use a cabergoline at times. Besides that, cabergoline is also used off-label for in the IVF condition. Now, IVF is nothing but the in vitro fertilization. Many people call it as a test tube baby. So when you are undergoing an IVF cycle, certain medications are prescribed, and this medication can overstimulate the ovary, and that can cause a condition called as a OHSS or ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome. To prevent this also, we use prolactin sometimes off-label. So these are the conditions where we use cabergoline drug. If your doctor has prescribed you cabergoline drug, then ask your doctor for what condition this medicine is prescribed, and you can ask your doctor accordingly. So now we know what are the conditions we use this for. Now let's see what other brand names are available. Now see, prolactin reducing drug cabergoline is available with a plenty many brand names. It depends on your location and in your city which drug is available. In India, the available drugs are like cabergoline, then we've got cabergoline, we've got the Dostinex. So all these are the certain brands. But as per your geographical location, you can use any brand provided it has a generic composition, that is a cabergoline. Now one very peculiar point about the cabergoline drugs is that this medication comes in a strip of 4 tablets. Unlike all other medications which usually comes in a strip of 10 or 15 tablets, this drug comes only in a 4 tablet form. Now talking about the dosage are available from 0.25 mg to 0.5 mg, 1 mg, it can even go up to 2 mg dose also. If we talk about the pricing, here in India, the pricing varies as per brand to brand, but 0.25 mg dose is available usually between 125 to 200 rupees, and 0.5 mg pricing can even go up to 200 to 400 rupees, but again, it depends on which brand you are purchasing. So based on that, you can keep this point also in mind. Cabergoline drug has to be consumed orally by mouth. It is not an injection, okay? And this drug can be used with or without food. You need not follow any kind of a special diet after taking this medication. Many times we prescribe this medicine after food to reduce the gastric side effects. Now, what are the other side effects which we are going to discuss later? So now let's understand how this medication works and what is its mechanism of action. Now see, to understand the mechanism of action, let's understand the normal physiology first. In our brain, we've got a gland called as a pituitary gland. This pituitary gland has a plenty many different types of cells, and all those different cells makes a different hormone. One such cell is called as a lactotroph cell. These lactotroph cells secretes the prolactin hormone, and this lactotroph cells has a very special cell called as a dopamine D2 receptor cells. Cabergoline drug works on this receptor cells, and that's how it reduces the production of the prolactin hormone. That's why we call it as a prolactin inhibitor. This drug is a very potent, it is very powerful. At the same time, this drug has a very long acting and it has a long life. The moment you consume this drug, within half an hour to 4 hours time, this medicine will be absorbed by your digestive system. And once this medicine reaches to your bloodstream, it shows its action. The action can begin within 3 hours and it can go even up to 7 days. Yes, the effect can even go up to 7 days. Once the medicine is entered into your body system, the metabolism starts. The metabolism mainly happens in the liver, and the elimination half-life of the cabergoline is anywhere between 60 to 80 hours. After the metabolism, this drug is mainly excreted in the bile, and that gets excreted via the feces. Very few metabolite gets excreted into the urine. Now many people have a question in their mind that, do I have to take the cabergoline drug lifelong? Now see, usually if your prolactin hormone is stable and is in the range since last 6 months, then in that case this medication can be stopped. But if not, then this medication might have to continue. Since cabergoline has a longer life, even if you stop taking this medicine, the prolactin reducing capacity of this medicine can still persist in your body up to 4 weeks. Now, one very important point I would like to discuss here is that many a times prolactin hormone irregularities happens in a woman, especially the reproductive age group women. So when this medicine cabergoline is prescribed to them, they are usually struggling with the infertility. So many a times we also use this drug for the infertility. And as I told you earlier, if your infertility is due to high prolactin level, the moment we give this medicine, prolactin hormone comes into the regular range and the women usually ovulate better. And nearly 80 to 85% of the women ovulate better and their infertility problem gets solved, and then they conceive. Now the question arises that, doctor, I have taken this medicine maybe few days or few weeks earlier. Will I have any effect on my pregnancy and on my fetus? Now see, there have been certain researches conducted. Now these researches were mainly done in the rats. Now this, as per this research, what we found that when a person had taken a cabergoline drug, there usually was a no unwanted outcome on the fetus, so and the pregnancy. There was very less or a minimal incidence of a miscarriage or an abortion and a fetal malformation. So please do not worry about it and just continue and enjoy your pregnancy as it is a normal pregnancy. One very important point is that, doctor, do I need to take this medicine during the pregnancy? See, this medication is usually not prescribed in the pregnancy. There are certain situations like a prolactinoma wherein a woman has a very large tumor. At that time, if at all we need to use any drug to reduce prolactin, we usually prefer bromocriptine drug, but usually cabergoline is not prescribed. Second condition is that, should you take this medicine during the lactation? Again, answer is no. See, lactation happens due to high prolactin. The moment you take a cabergoline, your prolactin hormone will reduce and that will also reduce or stop your lactation. So lactation will be affected and your breast milk also will be affected. So usually this medicine is not prescribed during the lactation. Now let's understand under what all condition this medicine is contraindicated. So very first condition is if you have any allergy to any component of this drug. Second condition is that since this medicine is metabolized in the liver, if you have any liver problem, again this medicine may not be the right for you. Third condition, if you have any heart problems, then also this medicine sometimes are not indicated. Another condition is that if you have any digestive issues, like you have a gastrointestinal ulcers or you have an active bleeding inside your digestive tract, again this medicine is not prescribed. Besides that, if you have a hypotension or a low blood pressure issue, then also this medicine may not be right for you because cabergoline drug also causes a hypotension. So your hypotension can get aggravated and which can be fatal. Along with that, if you are taking any medicine which contains a ketoconazole or erythromycin, again this medicine may not be right for you. So if your doctor has prescribed you, talk to your doctor why doctor has prescribed you, and if you have any of the conditions which I told you just now, again you discuss with your doctor so that your doctor and you can take a wise decision. So that's what we saw, the conditions where we prescribe, what is the mechanism of action, and where we don't prescribe the medicine. So now let's see what are the possible side effects of the cabergoline drug. Now side effects of the cabergoline drug are usually dose dependent. If you are taking a smaller dose like 0.25 milligram, then your side effects can be even absent or they can be even mild, which is very easily tolerable. If you are taking a very heavy dose, then your side effects can also become more severe. To reduce the side effect, we usually prescribe the dose as at a very smaller dose, that's 0.25 milligram. And then only we slowly up titrate after a period of 2 to 4 weeks. So your right dose may not be on your first sitting, but it can come after a few visits. Usually this drug is titrated over a 2 to 4 weeks period only. Now let's see what are the side effects. Before cabergoline drug came into the picture, we used to use a bromocriptine drug whose side effects were more severe. And then came the cabergoline. Now we have a one more class of a drug called as a quinagolide. However, this drug is not completely researched and they have not been medically used that extensively. But it is said that this drug, quinagolide, has a less side effects compared to the cabergoline drug. Now let's see what are the side effects. So most of the side effects are that of your digestive system or a gastrointestinal system. So very common side effects are nausea, vomiting, then gastric irritation or acidity. Some people have a pain in their abdomen. Sometimes there can be dryness of the mouth. Sometimes it can be even a constipation. So these are the possible digestive system side effects. other side effects of the happen that of the cardiovascular system, and there are two main side effects, that is a hypotension or a low blood pressure, and due to which you can even faint. So if you have a hypotension problem, especially when you're sleeping and you suddenly wake up, there's a sudden shift of the blood pressure, we call it as a orthostatic hypotension. If this is a very common in your case, then it is advisable that you wake up from your sleeping posture gradually and slowly to reduce the hypotension. Besides that, many people experience the edema or a swelling over their body, which is also a side effect of the cabergoline. Another side effect happens, and that is a neurological side effects. Many people experience too much of a tiredness or a sluggishness or a somnolence. Sometimes there can be a sleep disturbance. Many people experience insomnia, or where they are having a very difficulty falling to sleep. Sometimes there are a lot of behavioral changes also. Yes, there have been incidences wherein the people have entered into a wrong kind of a behavior, and where they have developed a habits of a gambling. Sometimes they even developed a sexual urges, which was never there before starting the cabergoline drug. Besides that, many people experience depression, change in their body movements. Many people have experienced a jerky, abnormal body movements. Some people develop a psychosis, and there are some people who have experienced even a hallucination. So these are the possible side effects also which can happen. As I told you earlier, side effects are dose dependent. It's not necessary that all the side effects will happen to you. If you develop any side effect, talk to your doctor and sort out, is there any other way so that you can avoid these side effects. Besides that, there is one very rare kind of a side effect called as a pulmonary fibrosis. In this, a person experiences a lot of cough, difficulty or some irritation in the chest area, or sometimes even a difficulty in breathing. So this kind of a rare side effect can also happen, so you can talk to your doctor. So now we saw what are the possible side effects. Now let's see whether this cabergoline drug has any interaction to do with other drugs. Now in this, we have the very first drug is an antihypertensive or a high blood pressure medicine. Now antihypertensive is prescribed because the blood pressure was high. To reduce this blood pressure, we use a high blood pressure or antihypertensive medications. Now cabergoline also causes a reduction in the blood pressure. So when you take both the drugs together, you might experience that your blood pressure is falling more than the normal range, and this can lead you into hypotension or a low blood pressure, and which can be fatal. So talk to your doctor. You might need to readjust your blood pressure medicine dose. Besides that, there are certain heart related medicines like a dopamine, then nitroglycerin. Those drugs also affect with your cabergoline drug. Besides that, there's one more class of a drug mainly used by the psychiatric patients, and these are a tricyclic antidepressant and a selective serotonin reuptake inhibitor class of antidepressant medicines. If you take this medicine, then it can put you into a severe or a fatal syndrome called as a serotonin syndrome. So if you develop such issues, again you talk to your doctor, and your doctor will advise you what to do, and your doctor might adjust your medication or might change the medicine as per your dose. Please remember, the dose of the cabergoline is an individual to individual. Do not self-medicate on this drug, because it is a very potent, very powerful drug and has to be taken only on a doctor's prescription. If you are taking this medicine, please write in the comment box that for what condition you are prescribed this medicine, and since how long you've been taking this medicine. If after watching this video, if you found some good information, then please click on the like button. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe so that you will get more and more health related, especially hormone related information. And then there is a bell icon. If you click there, as and when my new video will be published, you will be instantly notified for the same. Thank you for joining me till now, and I wish you great health, and we will meet again in our future with new upcoming video.